Okay, as we all know, square root of negative 1 is equal to I, but have we ever thought about what is square root of I? Oh well, as you know, I is the imaginary unit, and when you put the I inside the square root, do we still end up with a complex number? Most likely, isn't it? So, the way to deal with this is, well, we're just going to set up this to be a complex number, and we can write it down as, let's say square root of I is equal to the standard form of the complex number, which is a plus bi. And you know a and b are the real numbers, and the I is the imaginary unit, right? If we can find out what's the value of a and b, then we are done, right? Okay, so we'll just do this the algebraic way, meaning we can just go ahead and square both sides. So that you see, square root will cancel, and then on the left-hand side, we will just have the I, and on the right-hand side, we're just going to multiply this out, right? Okay, so for the first term, we will just have a square, and then for the second term, we are going to have plus 2 times this and that, which is 2abi, and then for the third term, we are going to take this and square, right? And let me put down the plus first, and let's see, let me do this on the side for you. Take bi and we square that, and you know this is b squared times I squared. And what is I squared? We know I squared is equal to negative 1. So all in all, this is negative b squared, right? So this is not plus, it should be minus, and we have the b squared from here, right? So just like this. And now we'll clean things up a little bit. On the left-hand side, we will still have just the I, but on the right-hand side, let's put all the real numbers together first, right? The real parts, I mean. So first, we'll have a squared minus b squared. They don't have the I, so let's put it together like this first. And then I will put this down next. So we add it with 2abi, okay? And as you can see, on the left-hand side, we have I, which is the same as saying 0 plus 1i, isn't it? And now, you can just kind of mix and match. Because 0 is the real number part, right? Which has to be the same as this. And this right here, we have a 1 in front of the I. On the right-hand side, we have 2ab in front of the I. So in other words, 1 has to match with 2ab. And this is how we can come with the system of equations and solve for a and b, right? So now, let's make this happen. So first, notice that I will have a squared minus b squared. A squared minus b squared equals to 0. So let's put that down right here first. Right here. A squared minus b squared equals to 0. And next, we have 2ab is equal to 1. Right? So that's the system of equations that we can use to solve. Okay, so from here, we're just going to be doing the substitution, right? On the second equation from here, we can divide both sides by 2a, if you would like. So you can see b is equal to 1 over 2a, and then just do the typical algebra. We can plug in this into this b right here. So we see that we have a squared minus the b becomes this 1 over 2a, and then you square that, and this is equal to 0, like this. And now we have a squared minus 1 squared, which is 1, 2 squared, which is 4 on the bottom, a squared on the bottom as well, this is equal to 0. And to solve this equation, I would prefer you guys to do it this way. Let's get the common denominator here. So multiply top and bottom by 4a squared, multiply this by 4a squared as well. So you see this is 4a to the fourth power minus 1 all over the same denominator, which is 4a squared, and this is equal to 0. How can we have a fraction equal to 0? The only chance is the top equals to 0, right? So all we have to do is 4a to the fourth power minus 1. It's equal to 0. Okay? And of course, do the typical things. Add 1 on both sides. So you have 4a to the 4 equal to 1. Divide by 4 on both sides. A to the 4th power is equal to 1 over 4. And then you're going to be taking the 4th root on both sides. And yeah, let's do it this way. Take the 4th root on both sides. It's like square root, do it twice, that kind of thing, all right? But this is the fourth root. This and that will cancel. However, when you take the even numbers root on both sides, you should technically put a plus minus, just like when you do the square roots. So a is equal to, you have plus or minus. This is the fourth root of 1 over 4, right? Okay, fourth root of 1, this is 1, no problem. Over, what's the fourth root of 4? Let's look at this right here down below, right? Fourth root of 4, just the denominator. This right here, let's do it this way. This 4 is the same as saying 2 squared, and the fourth root is the same as saying to the 1 over 4 power, okay? And when you're looking at this as the power form, you know the base stays the same, and we can just multiply the powers. So this is 2 times 1 over 4. And 2 times 1 over 4, you know it's equal to 1 half of the power. So this is 2 to the 1 half power. So 1 half power is the same as square root of 2, right? So this is how you do this little thing right here. Okay, so with that being said, on the bottom here, we have nothing but just square root of 2. That's the value of a, right? And in fact, you have two possibilities for a, and both are correct. You have two forms for square root of I altogether. Anyway, keep this in mind because I'm going to plug in this right here for the b, all right? So let me just write this down right here for you guys. When a is equal to positive 1 over square root of 2, and the other one is when a is equal to negative version of 1 over square root of 2. In both cases, right here you know, b is equal to this, right? 1 over 2a. So let me just write this down real quick again. B is equal to 1 over 2a. In this case, the a is 1 over square root of 2, so we have 1 over, this 2 is from this right here. This a is that, so I'll just put down 1 over square root of 2 like this, okay? And we can simplify this real quick. Just look at the denominator. You have 2 over square root of 2, which is still square root of 2. So this right here is square root of 2 on the bottom, and then it's still on the bottom like that. And likewise, in this case, you still have b is equal to 1 over 2a. So 1 over 2 is this 2, and this a is now that, which is negative 1 over square root of 2. In a parenthesis, same idea, but this time it's just a negative version of 1 over square root of 2. Okay, so first answer, a is this, b is that. Second answer, a is this, b is that. So in another word, ladies and gentlemen, square root of I, which is equal to a plus bi. First answer, a is this, b is that. So we will have 1 over square root of 2 plus 1 over square root of 2 I. That's the first answer. Second answer, when a is this and b is that. So I will just put down what is better, right? Or the second answer is that a is negative 1 over square root of 2, and we add with the negative b, right? B is negative, so we have minus 1 over square root of 2 I. Two answers. This, or that, and we are done. Cool, huh?